Let me say a few words about how to compute the gradient of feedforward neural network in matrix form. The formula we will get in at the end is so-called error or gradient backpropagation. We will consider a neural network which gets input x, and it multiplied by first layer matrix of weights W1 transpose, and bias B1 is added, and then we will take element-wise nonlinear function. It's often sigmoid, but maybe other functions, which is described here. Our notation of element-wise function is phi of u is just vector of phi of first component, phi of second component, and so on. And this is the first layer of our network, and we continue so on to the second layer, and the output of our network we will compare with desirable output for purpose of training. And E is some measure of error. E is a scalar obtained by applying function psi. Psi may be sum of squares, but maybe other penalty functions for error. In algebraic form, we can write all this process in following way. So we take x, multiply it by W1 transpose, add bias B1, take nonlinear function phi1, multiply the results by W2 transpose, add bias B2, and apply the second nonlinear function phi2. In this way, we get output of our network, and we denote it capital F of XW, and W is general notation for all weights and biases in our network. Afterwards, we compute error. Error is some measure, sum of squares or some other functions, of say difference between output of our network and desired output Y. Y and capital F may be scalars and or maybe vectors. Our goal for minimizing the error, our goal is to compute gradient of error. Actually, the goal will be in the end compute gradient of the error with respect to W, but as intermediate and more simple goal, let us compute the gradient of error with respect to x input vector, as an example. Okay, like we already told, if we have a chain function psi of f of x, psi is a scalar function of vector variable, and f is a vector function of vector variable. We already showed that gradient of this chain function is just multiplying transposed Jacobian of inner function f by gradient of external function. So in order to compute gradient of E, we need to be able to compute Jacobian and its transpose. Because our function F is a chain of other linear and nonlinear function, the Jacobian, like we already learned, Jacobian of this chain is just the product of Jacobians. So Jacobian of the first linear transformation is just W1 transpose. Jacobian of element-wise function, phi1, we have here element-wise function phi1. So if we have element-wise function, it's easy to show that its Jacobian is just diagonal matrix, where on diagonal we will have derivatives of those element-wise functions, and all other elements of this matrix are zero. You can verify it just straightforward by definition of Jacobian. You can ask what is the derivative of this function with respect to U1. And of course, derivative of first output will be just phi1 prime, and derivative with respect to all other outputs will be zero, and this in the end will give us this matrix. Okay, so we have a way to compute Jacobians of every element in this chain, and the resulting Jacobian is just product. So we had chain W1, and then phi1, and then W2, and then phi2. So we should put the product of those Jacobians. Now, we are interested in transpose of Jacobian of F. And it's very easy. It's transpose of a product of matrices. It's product of transposes taken in reverse order. So this will be transpose of Jacobian, and we multiply it by gradient of psi. Sorry, so here it should be gradient of psi, but actually our E is psi, so it's the same notation. Gradient of E with respect to residual R is the same as gradient of psi. So we have this nice formula. So in order to compute gradient of x, what should we do? We should compute gradient of this output error function, output term, and then sequentially propagate it through our network in reverse order, only the nonlinear functions themselves we will substitute by the diagonal matrix of the derivatives, if you will want to compute it in scalar form, just with the derivatives. And multiplication by, say, matrix W2, we substitute by multiplication by W2 transpose, and so on. And in this way, we get this, in very simple derivation, we get a very well-known formula of error backpropagation, which is widely used in neural networks. One more word, in order to compute gradients with respect to W, we will need one more step, and we will talk about it later.